that I know of. We're actually bigger than Black Enterprise already. We actually have a bigger platform than Black Enterprise. So we're really on our way to building something special. So feel free to subscribe to theblackfinancialchannel.com for daily financial news and commentary from a Black perspective. Everything that we talk about comes through the lens of Blackness, because I told you guys that our number one objective is to see the improvement of the Black community. We don't care about nothing and nobody else. Now, here's the thing. Here's what's interesting. So I saw Stephen A. Smith debating with Terrell Owens. Did anybody else see, give me a yes or no, if you saw Stephen A. Smith go pound for pound, toe for toe with Terrell Owens. Let me know if you saw that. Give me a yes or no in the chat if you saw, you know, even a clip of it or heard something about it or something like that. Terrell Owens is a, he's a guy that used to be in the NFL. He was an excellent, excellent, excellent player. He seems like a good brother. I don't know him personally. And they were debating race on ESPN. And I don't like ESPN having these deep conversations on race. I know for them, it's like, oh, this is great. This is a ratings bonanza. People are going to love it. Everybody's going to watch it. But I don't like it at all, because I don't like it when white-owned corporations like ESPN, which is owned by Disney, which I actually am a stockholder, I'm a shareholder in Disney. I have nothing against Disney. In fact, I admire the way they run their company. I actually went through the masterclass of Bob Iger, who is the CEO of Disney, because I like to see how people like that think, because I have respect there. But I don't like white-owned companies controlling important conversations on race. Why is that important? Well, because when they're controlling the conversation, when they say, hey, we want you to debate your Blackness on our white-owned platform, what it does is it creates these weird, unnecessary divisions, this very strange divide and conquer. Why? Well, because they're deciding who gets to participate in the debate in the first place. You know, seriously, like, I'll ask you a yes or no question. Yes or no, yes or no, yes or no. Let me see. Dr. Claude Anderson, who wrote Powernomics, who was an expert on race, who knows far more about race and racism than a Stephen A. Smith or even a Terrell Owens or anybody, or even a Michael Eric Dyson who came on there, right? Do you think ESPN would ever have Dr. Claude Anderson go on their network to talk about race in America? A man who knows more about race and racism and racial history than anybody that they've ever had on their platform? No, they wouldn't. They not that I know of, they never have. But they'll bring in like a Lil Wayne and be like, so Lil Wayne, what do you think about your race in America? Well, you know, I think that we need to all sip our purple. We need to forget about this shit, because I need my bitches and my hoes, because I got to go get high after the show. Right. That's what they do. They'll pick some of the most ignorant, backward Negroes on earth, or misinformed Black people, to debate the most important issues of the day. Farrakhan. That's another example. Farrakhan. If you've ever seen Farrakhan, give me a yes or no if you've ever heard a Farrakhan speech, if you've ever seen a Farrakhan television appearance, read a Farrakhan book, article, seen him on YouTube, anybody, yes or no, yes or no. Has anybody ever heard Minister Louis Farrakhan speak? Yes or no? Okay. A lot of you have heard him, maybe through the Million Man March, something like that. Here's what's fascinating, right? So they'll bring in a Lil Wayne, high and drunk, got baby's mamas, spreading STDs, you know, out here trying to kill himself every day, teaching young Black men how to murder themselves, right? They'll bring him on and ask him important questions about important issues. Or some guy who was a football player. No disrespect to football players, but you're not a sociology expert. You're not an expert on racial history in America, but you're an expert on football. If they want to know the X's and O's and why the Cowboys beat the Eagles last night, then you're that guy. You're the guy, because you can break down the defensive structure and the schemes and talk about why the linebackers were able to break through the offensive line and get to the quarterback so easily. And you could talk about that, but you're not the guy who needs to be talking about a sensitive and important issue like America's racial history and racial politics of the day. That's out of your job description. You know, and just like, you don't hear me really. I mean, I might make a quick commentary about the game last night and what I saw and how I think my Ohio State Buckeyes are going to win it all, because they're just some bad motherfuckers this year. I could talk about that, but you would be stupid to put me next to Stephen A. Smith and have me debate Stephen A. over the X's and O's of football. Like, that would be crazy. Right. But yet an ESPN will go grab a Negro off the street and be like, we want to ask you the most important questions about race in America that are going to affect the millions of people and be heard all around the world and maybe even affect government policy. Tell us what you think. And then they say something crazy. And it ends up making us look ridiculous. It makes us look stupid, right? So I don't like ESPN controlling the conversations. They get to decide which Negroes to elevate and which ones to demote. When you have guys in there that get a little bit too real, those guys disappear. They never come back. But when you get somebody like a Stephen A. who plays ball with the way their network thinks, which is it's a white supremacist organization. A lot of them are, but it doesn't mean that they're necessarily worse than other companies, but they are. I mean, white supremacist, white people, and white culture kind of drives everything, drives the entire system. You know, they are a personification of systematic racism, right? No diss on them, but they are, right? Many of the hosts are black. I know why a lot of their hosts are black on the daytime sports shows, because they figured out, one of the actual commentators told me this. He said that the executives at ESPN figured out that black male unemployment was incredibly high and they could benefit from that. He said they realized that a lot of brothers, because they didn't have jobs, were sitting at home during the day watching sports. So that's why they started putting more black analysts on the air, because they knew that they could exploit the fact that so many black men are unemployed that they're sitting at home just watching TV, like Housewives, like Motel House says, yes, like Housewives. So.